so smoothly that the king himself will be able to sleep on board, even in the darkest storm. The third tree said, someday I wish to remain a tree. But not just any tree. I want to grow so straight and so tall that I will tower over the clouds, and all who pass this hill will see me standing here, pointing the way to heaven. Years passed, seasons came and went. Then one day, three woodsmen came up the hill, carrying axes. They cut down the first tree. They cut down the second tree. And they cut down the third tree. The first tree was carried to a carpenter's shop. There it was stripped of its bark and trimmed of its branches and was made into a box. But not the treasure chest of a wealthy man. It was made into a simple feed box for animals and placed in a barn. The second tree was carried to a dockyard. It too stripped of its bark and trimmed of its branches and was made into part of a boat. But not the mast of a great sailing ship. It was carved into a wooden bench and nailed to the back of a fishing vessel. And the third tree, when it was stripped of its bark and trimmed of its branches, proved to be too flawed for any common usage. It was cut off the tarp and laid aside in the lumberyard. More years passed. Seasons came and went. Then one day, into the barn where the first tree lay, now a feed box for animals, there came a young woman and a young man. And that very night, the woman had her firstborn child and wrapped him in soft clothes and laid him in the box. And the dream of the first tree came true. For that night he held a treasure more precious than any in the world. More years passed. And then one day, into the boat where the second tree was, now we would admit, there stepped the young teacher. The boat was sailed to the middle of a lake, and there the man fell asleep on the seat with his head on a cushion. A terrible storm arose. Waves crashed over the side of the boat. The fishermen on board, in fear for their lives, awoke the man who stood, and with one word, silenced the wind and calmed the waves. And the dream of the second tree came true. For that day he had carried the king of all kings. And what of the third tree? Well, the day came when the soldiers found that tree and laid it across the back of a wounded man who struggled to talk.